Anybody who's wheeled the solid axle early Toyota trucks has probably had to deal with one of these before. This is a Toyota Birfield joint, and this one is actually attached to the short side axle shaft. The Birfield joint's a great design. It allows free range of motion on this joint, which actually powers your front drive wheel. But Toyota, bless their hearts, made these things so hard that even though they last forever in a stock application, when you start putting bigger wheels and tires and other things like that, they don't survive the shock loads and tend to shatter. Toyota's got a little clip, a little round clip, that is on the end of those splines, and what happens is you compress it when you're putting it in, and then it expands open and locks in, so everything can't come off. Toyota actually calls for you to use a drift and a hammer and pound on the inner star there to try and force the bell over the top of and off of that inner clip, but I've got a better way to do it, and faster. Okay, so basically this is my Birfield separating tool. It's just a length of quarter inch wall steel tubing, and I went as far as just to weld a little plate to the top of it with a hole. So I placed my length of pipe on a piece of plywood there on the concrete floor, and the idea is we're just going to let gravity bust that thing out by hitting it hard against there. Let's see what we get here. This one hasn't been off ever. There it goes. Two hits. And it's off. Now let's see if we got lucky and see if we can find the little clip. Looks like it stayed in there, so I'll have to fish that little clip out. But that's separating the burf quick and easy. Now you don't have to weld a plate on there. You could actually just do it right to the base of here. I like the plate because it spreads the impact over the bell of the burf and over that inner star a little bit. And I have plenty of scrap laying around in a welder, so why not? But yeah, you can just use a length of pipe. Now obviously this pipe is going to be too short for the long side shaft. I can clamp this in the vise and leave enough room underneath it and a piece of wood down on the ground and hit it over there in the vise. And the long shaft is so heavy, it'll practically just pop itself out just about every time on the first hit. So now that we got the thing separated, I can show you what we're dealing with here. Here's the clip that was originally around that groove in there, and it obviously broke into two pieces when I was fishing it out. The groove goes up inside the Birfield, and you put the clip on there when you're installing it, and then when you go to put the burf on and you hammer it home, that clip kind of pushes down, goes through, and then expands, which keeps it from coming off. But obviously with the clip broken and out of there, it just comes right off. And now you can disassemble your Birfield and clean it. It's totally possible to disassemble these all the way, get the balls out, get the inner race and the inner star completely out of there, clean everything and reassemble it. But that's probably a whole nother video. It's not difficult, but you do have to do it in a specific order, and the parts have to be oriented in a certain way to get them back in. It's like a little jigsaw puzzle. So back in the day, the original solution for strengthening the Birfield was that somebody came up with welding a ring around the outside edge of the Birfield. That would help strengthen it from blowing out under heavy shock loads. You know, guys being what they are, we started getting bigger and bigger tires, and anything bigger than a 33, and this poor joint in stock form just doesn't survive well. So the original solution, welding a ring to the outside here, helped a lot, strengthening it, keeping it from blowing out. The problem being is it ate into the turning radius a little bit, and you couldn't disassemble the Birfield anymore if there was a ring welded out here. So you couldn't run the inner snap ring, because if you broke off your shaft right here, you would have a heck of a time getting out that stub if the snap ring was still in place. And you don't want to be trying to do that out in the field. So what they came up with was welding a couple of tack welds around the edge of the splines here, which would keep this shaft from walking too far into the differential. The inner axle shaft can't go any farther into the Birfield because of the outer snap ring here. And of course the Birfield is held in place from walking around too much by this snap ring here, which you can access by removing the outer dial on the hub. So in order to keep this shaft from walking into the diff, a couple of tack welds in here did the trick. Well, after a couple of years, Bobby Long of Super Axles started making completely new aftermarket Birfields that they call long fields that are made out of much, much better material. It's hardened to the right hardness, so it's still got a little bit of give in it, and they started making thicker outer cages and better materials all the way around, and those joints will survive some enormous tires. I got a buddy running 39.5 IROCs with an extremely heavy foot and a really strong engine, and he hasn't seemed to have been able to break these things. They also make aftermarket inner shafts now that are way stronger. But anyway, I hope you've enjoyed our little how-to and little history of the Birfield, and I hope we see you out on the trail, and be safe and enjoy your wheeling.